لا محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة.
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا الدين القويم، وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صفيه وخليله، خير نبي اجتباه وهدى ورحمة للعالمين أرسله. All praise and thanks be to Allah over and over again. All praise and thanks be to Allah who guided us to this straight religion. We would have not been guided had Allah not guided us. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship but Allah alone, without any partner with Him. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His servant and messenger. He sent Him as a mercy to all creatures. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala hadha al-Nabi al-Ummi al-Habib wa ala ali baytihi al-tayyibin al-tahirin wa ashabihi al-mujahideen ajma'in wa man tabi'a hudahum wa iqtafa atharahum وَسَلِّمْ تَسْلِيمًا كَثِيرًا. O Allah, raise the position of our beloved Prophet and shower him with more blessings along with his family members, the pure ones, and along with his striving companions and all those who follow their footsteps until the Day of Judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Hashr, Ayah 18 to 20, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. O you who believe, fulfill your duties to Allah, fear Allah, and let every soul examine and check what it has sent ahead for tomorrow, what it has done for its eternal future.
ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون.
Do not be of those who forgot Allah, so He made them forget their own souls and their own selves. Those are the disobedient ones, the rebellious ones.
لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون.
Not equal. Not equal are the dwellers of the fire and the dwellers of paradise. It is the dwellers of paradise that will be successful.
Imam al-Tirmidhi narrates that Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said,
أَعْمَارُ أُمَّتِي مَا بَيْنَ السِّتِّينَ إِلَى السَّبْعِينَ وَأَقَلُّهُمْ مَنْ يَجُوزُ ذَلِكَ.
The lives of my community, the lives of my ummah are between the 60s to the 70s, and a few of them who will live more.
Imam Malik, may Allah have mercy on him, in his Muwatta, says that the trustworthy people of knowledge told him that that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was seen or was shown the lives of his community and the lives of people before his community. So he felt that the lives of his own people are shorter than the lives of previous people, and that they will, and he feared that they will not do as much good deeds as the previous ones did. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him Laylatul Qadr, which is best or better than 1,000 months.
Uriya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a'mar al-nasi qablahu aw ma sha'a Allah min dhalik فكأنه تقاصر أعمار أمته أن لا يبلغوا من العمل مثل الذي بلغ غيرهم في طول العمر فأعطاه الله ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. فهو الحريص علينا صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He is so anxious and careful about us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about him in Surah At-Tawbah, last two ayat.
لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم.
A messenger came to you from among yourselves. It is very hurting to him when you make mistakes. He is ardently anxious over you. He is full of concern for you to be rightly guided, to repent, to be happy in this life, to enter paradise, to be saved from hellfire. He is so anxious about you. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. For the believers, he is full of pity and kind and mercy.
So he felt that our lives are shorter than the lives of previous people. So he prayed to Allah, and Allah gave him Laylatul Qadr.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr, wa ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر.
We have revealed it in the night of Al-Qadr. And how awesome the night of Al-Qadr is. It is best than 1,000 months. Worshipping Allah in ليلة القدر is better than worshipping Allah 1,000 months, which don't include ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر, as its name indicates, is the night of honor and glory, because the Holy Quran was revealed in that night, was brought from Al-Lawh al-Mahfuz, the preserved tablet, down to the house of glory in the lower heaven, ila bayt al-izza fi as-sama' ad-dunya. Then it started being revealed through angel Jibril alayhi salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and continued according to the occasions of that era into 23 years. And it was started to being revealed on that night as well. this Quran made, and the revelation of this Quran in that night made it an honorable night. The night of honor, the night of Qadr, glory and might. Because this Quran is the message of Allah to His people, sent with the best of His messengers, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because the one who will celebrate this night and who will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this night, he will be of Qadr. He will be honorable one. He will have honor and glory in the hereafter. And it is also the night in which the angels are crowded, and so crowded in this life, in this world, in this dunya. And they will be more and as many as the bubbles, and more than the number of the bubbles in this world. And it is also the night of Qadr, which means the night of decree. Because in this night as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assign the measures and the commands of life and death and sustenance and all things that will be decreed that year. He will assign it on that night to the angels, who will know what will happen and who will carry upon and act upon these commands. It is also the night of multiplying your deeds. The good deeds and worship in this night is better than worshipping 1,000 nights which don't include Laylatul Qadr. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنَّ هَذَا الشَّهْرَ قَدْ حَضَرَكُمْ فِيهِ لَيْلَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ مَنْ حُرِمَ خَيْرَهَا فَقَدْ حُرِمَ الْخَيْرَ كُلَّهُ وَلَا يُحْرَمُ خَيْرُهَا إِلَّا مَحْرُومٌ. Narrated by Imam Ibn Majah, he says, this month of Ramadan has come. It has a night which is better than 1,000 nights. The one who is deprived from its good and its benefits has really lost all good. وَلَا يُحْرَمُ خَيْرُهَا إِلَّا مَحْرُومٌ. And no one will be deprived of its good except a deprived person, a loser. So, it is a great night. It is the greatest night. It is better than all our lives. We live, let's say 70, 80 years. More than half of our lives are spent in food, drink, playing, sleeping, work. And what's left for worship is not more than 10 years. Maximum. So worshipping Allah in this night is better than your own lives 10 times. Yes. خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Better than 1,000 months, which is equal about 83 years, 4 months. This is Allah's blessing to the community of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Allah's love to His creatures. What about its time? Imam Abu Dawood narrated that Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Laylatul Qadr that it will be the 27th night of Ramadan. Imam Muslim narrated that Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu said that a man saw that Laylatul Qadr was that he saw it in the 27th night of Ramadan. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أرى رؤياكم في العشر الأواخر فاطلبوها في الوتر منها. I see that you're seeing it in the last 10 days of Ramadan. So seek Laylatul Qadr in the odd days of the last 10 days of Ramadan. The 21st, the 23rd, 25th, 27th, 29th. These are the times in which we should seek this night. And when we read the whole hadith and traditions of the Prophet ﷺ about Laylatul Qadr, we find that it is not in a specific night by itself. It moves in these last 10 nights of Ramadan. So those who would really like to benefit from this greatest night should seek it in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. All the last 10 nights of Ramadan, starting with the 21st night until the last night. And this is what your beloved, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to do. Sallu alayhi. He used to make i'tikaf, as Imam al-Bukhari narrates, that Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make i'tikaf 10 days in each Ramadan. And in the day in which he passed away, he made i'tikaf 20 days. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah told him that it was the year in which he will pass away. So he did his best, and he did more worship, and he drew himself closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, despite the fact he is the best of his creatures, despite the fact he is the one who doesn't have any sins, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he used to make i'tikaf, he used to seclude himself in the masjid all the last 10 days. What did he used to do as well, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim narrate that Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used, when the night, the last 10 days of Ramadan come, he used to stay up late, to stay up at night, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all night, and to wake up his family members, and to prepare himself and roll up his sleeves and stay awake to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to seek Laylatul Qadr in those blessed nights. كان إذا دخل العشر أحيا ليلة وأيقظ أهله وشد مئزره صلى الله عليه وسلم. Imam Muslim also narrates that Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to exert himself and do more worship in the last 10 days of Ramadan more than any other days. كان يجتهد في العشر الأواخر ما لا يجتهد في غيره صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is, dear brothers and sisters, this is Allah's messenger. He is the one who will first knock at the doors of paradise. It will be said, who is it? He will say, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. They will say to him, we were commanded not to open to anyone except to you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enlightened his heart and raised his position. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. He is the one whose name is connected with Allah's name. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. He is the one that if you deny, your Islam will never be accepted. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So, this was his effort in his character and his deeds in seeking the last 10 days of Ramadan and in seeking Laylatul Qadr. So what about us? Want and shouldn't we be more careful and more keen on benefiting from these blessed nights, and especially the night of Al-Qadr? Shouldn't we prepare our hearts to this night, to the lights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this night? And listen what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith narrated by Imam al-Tabarani. إِنَّ لِرَبِّكُمْ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ نَفَحَاتٍ فَتَعَرَّضُوا لَهَا. Your Lord has in your days breezes and showers and rains of mercy in some of your days. So expose yourself to these rains of mercy. Prepare yourself to these rains of mercy and these showers of mercy. Prepare your heart. Get ready for them. Be with Allah in these blessed days that He told you about. Be with Him to get benefit of these days. فَتَعَرَّضُوا لَهَا. Then listen what he says. And this sentence might be the reason for your eternal happiness. He says, لَعَلَّ أَحَدَكُمْ أَنْ يُصِيبَهُ مِنْهَا نَفْحَةٌ لَا يَشْقَى بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا. Maybe one of you in these blessed days will get some of these rains of mercy, of these divine lights, with which he will never be unhappy. He will get the eternal happiness. What does that mean? This means Allah will admit you in his paradise. From now, he will decide. He knows, and he will admit you. And this means he will give you success and guide you to do good deeds and to die having the good deeds much more than your bad deeds. So be with your Muslim brothers in this night. Stick to the masjid in these nights, because these great chances will never come again. Yes, these 10 nights particularly will never come again. Another 10 nights, other 10 nights will come, but these 10 nights have gone. They will never come back again. And who knows? Maybe we will not live until the next month. Allah knows best. So stick to the masjid and stay with your Muslim brothers and celebrate these nights, so that you will help one another and support one another and remind one another to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these nights. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad, إن الشيطان ذئب الإنسان كذئب الغنم يأخذ الشاة القاصية فإياكم والشعاب وعليكم بالجماعة والعامة والمسجد. The devil is the wolf of the human being, just like the wolf of the sheep. It takes and it attacks the far and the isolated sheep. So beware of being alone and being far from the Muslim group, and stick to the jama'ah, stick to the Muslim group, and stick to the Muslim public, and stick to the masjid. Dear believer, don't you have sins that you need to be forgiven? Don't you have needs that you wish to be fulfilled? Don't you have a hard heart that you wish to be softened? Don't you have a dry eye that you wish to shed some tears out of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't you have many needs and prayers that you hope to be answered and responded to by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't you like to be set up free from hellfire? We all need that. So this is the chance before you. Do not deprive yourself from this great chance. Make use of this chance for your eternal future. Yes. So don't lose it. رزقك مقسوم فلا تخف عليه فلن تحرم منه ولكن من حرم رحمة الله ومغفرته هو المحروم. Your provision, your sustenance, your work is decreed by Allah. You will take it. Don't worry about it. But worry about your own future. Worry whether Allah forgave you or not. اللهم لا تجعلنا من المحرومين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, do not make us of the deprived ones, and make us of those who benefit from these blessed nights. You are the most merciful of the merciful. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمدا لا يبيد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إله أقرب إلينا من حبل الوريد. All the praise and thanks be to Allah over and over again. How should we celebrate or worship Allah in this night? The Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. The one who celebrates or worship Allah in the night of Al-Qadr, believing in Allah and seeking the reward from Allah, then all his or her sins will be forgiven. The best time to celebrate this night is the last third of night, because it is, as the Prophet ﷺ told us, the best time to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, waqt al-sahar, before the dawn of prayer, the last third of the night, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws himself closer to his people, shower them with his mercy, opens his doors, and he asks and says, is there anyone who needs to be forgiven so that I forgive him? Is there anyone who needs anything so that I will give him? And he keeps saying this to his creatures until the dawn rises. What should we do in this night? And should we stay up all the night from Isha to dawn prayer? Not necessarily at all. The best thing that we used to do, and that I urge you to do, just to pray the Isha prayer in congregation. And this is the first and the most important thing to get the reward of praying half of the night. مَنْ صَلَّى الْعِشَاءَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ نِصْفَ اللَّيْلِ. Then pray some Taraweeh, then go to sleep. Go to sleep and wake up 2 hours before the Fajr prayer and come to the masjid. This is the best time, better than staying up all night from Isha to the dawn prayer, and you will find yourself at the last third of night, you are drowsy and you cannot pray and you just want to go to sleep. Do not deprive yourself of at least 2 hours before the dawn prayer in this blessed night. Do anything not to lose these 2 hours. Take a vacation, take a holiday, do whatever you can do, because it is a chance that might not come again. And do your best to communicate with your relatives and care about them and ask about their affairs and show mercy to them, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you mercy and will have mercy on you in these blessed nights. In these blessed nights. الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله الأماني. The mindful, the knowledgeable person is the one who criticizes his own self. And the disabled ones, the loser is the one who just gives himself its own desires, its own ego, and just keep wishing and wishing. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن السادة الحنفاء الأربعة الخلفاء ساداتنا وموالينا الكرام ذوي القدر العلي أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وسائر الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات، المسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. Oh Allah, forgive Muslims and believers, men and women, the dead and the living ones. You are the one who responds to our prayers. اللهم هذا حالنا لا يخفى عليك، وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر بين يديك، عاملنا اللهم بالإحسان إذ الفضل منك وإليك. اللهم أكرمنا برضاك ولا تشغلنا بسواك، وفرحنا يوم لقاك. اللهم اجعل ألسنتنا لاهجة بذكرك، واجعل قلوبنا مطيعة لأمرك، واجعل جوارحنا قائمة بشكرك. اللهم إنا نسألك من كل خير سألك منه سيدنا محمد، ونعوذ بك من كل شر استعاذ بك منه سيدنا محمد. O Allah, we ask you from each good our Prophet asked you for, and we seek refuge with you from each evil that your Prophet sought refuge with you from. اللهم إن فاتتنا ليلة القدر نرجوك أن لا تحرمنا من الأجر. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر واجعلنا فيها من المقبولين. O Allah, make us witness the night of Al-Qadr and make us among those who you will accept in this night. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم فرج عن أهلنا في الشام وفي مصر ما هم فيه. اللهم فرج عن المسلمين والمظلومين في كل مكان. اللهم إنا نستنصرك أهلنا وإخواننا. اللهم ليس لهم ناصر إلا أنت. اللهم قد خذلهم القريب والبعيد وليس لهم مجير وناصر سواك. يا الله يا أرحم الراحمين، اقبل شهداءهم وعاف جرحاهم وفك أسراهم وانصرهم على من ظلمهم وعاداهم. اللهم عليك بطاغية الشام وطاغية مصر وجميع الطغاة فإنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر، وكل من أيدهم وساندهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا يا رب العالمين. واغفر اللهم لنا ولمشايخنا ولوالدينا ولأصحاب الحقوق علينا وللمسلمين أجمعين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. أصلحنا وأصلح بنا وأصلح ذات بيننا. ربنا لا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، واغفر لنا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
Straighten your line, please, shoulder to shoulder. Complete the first row, please. Complete the first row. And just leave space for one person. Yeah. The second row, please. Someone in this space, please do not leave spaces between shoulders. Someone, please, in this place here. Or just move. Manar, move. Yeah. Yeah, shoulder. Move, move, please.
Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين
إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله. استغفر الله. اللهم أنت السلام يا سيدي. باركت يا ذا الجلال. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. إن شاء الله. Very quick announcements. First of all, إن شاء الله may Allah accept our good deeds. We have the Taraweeh prayer every day, inshallah, from 10 to 11 in these last 5 days. We have Tahajjud prayer in the last third of night, starting at 4 o'clock. And about Laylatul Qadr's Ihya, inshallah, it will start 3 a.m. on Sunday, inshallah. So Sunday, 3 a.m. until 5 a.m. Inshallah, we will have Tasabih prayer and Dhikr and Witr with Qunut. And there will be suhoor, inshallah, from 5 to 5:25. So, Salat Taraweeh, inshallah, yawmiyan min al-ashra hatta al-hadiyata ashra, tahajjud yawmiyan sa'a al-rabi'a qabla al-fajr, ihya' laylat al-qadr, inshallah, sa'a al-thalithi fajran, fajr yawm al-ahad, hatta sa'a al-khamisi, inshallah. Suhoor, inshallah, mutawaffir min al-khamisi hatta al-khamisi u 25 daqiqa. Also, we have celebrating the Eid night, inshallah, laylat al-Eid. For those who would like, it is also a blessed night. Laylat al-Eid, inshallah, will be
the Eid night will be inshallah Wednesday from 10 to 11. Inshallah, we will have some dhikr, dua and prayer and nasheed. As for Salat al-Eid, inshallah, the Eid prayer will be in this masjid, inshallah, on Thursday at 9:30 sharp, inshallah, 9:30. The last, also tonight we have, inshallah, dhikr and nasheed and taraweeh, of course, from 10 to 11:30, and there will be also batlak, inshallah. Last thing, which is very important, zakatul fitr. I talked about zakatul fitr in the talks between the taraweeh prayer, but just a reminder to some of our brothers who were not there. Zakatul fitr, dear brothers, is legislated by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Faradaha Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on every Muslim on himself, every Muslim who has the food for the day of the Eid and the night of the Eid. If you have the food and drink for the day of the Eid and the night of the Eid for yourself and your family, and you have $11 extra, you should pay these $11 minimum. So on yourself, $11 on each of your family members. On yourself and all those whom you are responsible for, your wife, your children who did not reach puberty, and all those that you are responsible for, you have to pay a minimum of $11 for each person. And this Zakatul Fitr, of course, it is prescribed to make up the shortcomings of your fasting. If you had some shortcomings in your fasting, this Zakatul Fitr, the charity of breaking the fast, came to make up these shortcomings. لِتَجْبُرَ نَقْصَ الصِّيَامِ. And it is also charity to the poor and to the needy ones. And it is very preferred to pay it soon. And if you pay it after the Eid prayer, it is not accepted, and this is a sin. This is a sin if you do not pay it before the Eid prayer. You must pay it before the Eid prayer. And it's preferable to pay it very early and soon so that the poor will benefit from it. But if you do not pay it before the Eid prayer, then you have to repent to Allah and pay it as soon as possible. This is what I would like to tell you about. Now, the last thing, just I would like to tell you a hadith about the Prophet ﷺ on this regard, on charity. So those who have to go, they can go. Very, very beautiful hadith about charity. The Prophet ﷺ says, actually it's three hadith, not one hadith. Three hadith, very nice hadith. The first one, narrated by Imam Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah, the Prophet ﷺ says, ثَلَاثٌ أُقْسِمُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأُحَدِّثُكُمْ حَدِيثًا فَاحْفَظُوهُ مَا نَقَصَ مَالُ عَبْدٍ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ. I swear by Allah on three things. The Prophet doesn't need to swear, but just this is an emphasis. And he says, and I am telling you a hadith, so memorize it. Pay attention to it. مَا نَقَصَ مَالُ عَبْدٍ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ. Your wealth will never be decreased if you give charity. Never. Because as-sadaqa or as-zakah means an-nama. As-zakah means increasement. When you pay zakah, your wealth will be increased. And the other hadith, look about this nice understanding of our beloved Prophet ﷺ. Once he slaughtered sheep, and Sayyidina Aisha gave to the neighbors, and she only left the shoulder of the sheep, because she knew the Prophet ﷺ likes to eat the shoulder of the sheep. كَانَ يُحِبُّ الْكَتِفْ وَالْذِرَاءِ مِنَ الشَّاتِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. So she gave everything from the sheep to the poor, and she left the shoulder for the Prophet ﷺ. And when he came, she felt a little distressed. She said, I have only been able to save this. That is the only part that I saved. The shoulder is the only part that I have saved, O Rasulullah. He said, never. This is the only part that you have not saved. قالت يا رسول الله ذهبت الشات وبقي الكتف.
قال لا، بل قولي بقيت الشات وذهب الكتف. The whole sheep is preserved and saved for us because we gave it as a charity and we did not save the shoulder of the sheep. Subhanallah. This is the understanding of a Muslim. When you give a charity, you are saving it. You are putting it in your future account with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And last hadith narrated by Imam Tabarani, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Inna as-sadaqata la tutfi'u 'an ahliha harra al-qubur. Wa inna ma yastadhillu al-mu'minu yawm al-qiyamati fi dhilli sadaqatih." The charity puts off and extinguishes the heat and puts down the heat of the graves. And on the day of judgment, the believers will be shaded. On that time when the sun will come closer to people and they will start sweating, your charity will shade you on that night, on that day, on that horrible position. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who listen to this speech and follow its best. Sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
That base under the bulletin board is what we kept aside for the fitra, the capital fitra. So please leave the money there. Now I also heard that ISNA is saying that the zakat is $13. So anywhere between $11 and $13. If you can afford to put $13, well, that's what they calculated. Anywhere.
That's the minimum, right?
Yes, minimum.
Absolutely. This
for,
is
for every person.
Yeah, absolutely. $11 is the approximate minimum, not less than that. And of course, pay 15 at least, and you will never lose, inshallah. Pay as much as you can. Pay. This is a chance, inshallah.